all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference. We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
When you join the HBCU family, you become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Athletic Conference encourage and promote good sportsmanship by student athletes.
We welcome you back to Gulfport, Mississippi, the Gulfport Sportsplex. We started with 8, and we are down to 3.
We request your
2023 SWAC Softball Tournament. The Lady Braves of Alcorn defeated and eliminated Bethune-Cookman 1-0 in a terrific game, to say the least. And speaking of the Lady Braves, they are playing their 4th elimination game. After losing their first game 1-0 to Bama State, they eliminated Florida A&M, Bama State, and Bethune-Cookman. Grambling, on the other hand, was perfect until they lost 5-2 to Prairie View. So the Prairie View A&M Lady Panthers are in the championship game. And here's what we have coming up for you. If the Lady Braves win this game, they eliminate Grambling, and it will be Alcorn and Prairie View for the championship. What that also will mean is that the third game of the day for the Lady Braves in a normal situation. That won't happen. If Alcorn wins this game, they eliminate Grambling, and we will reconvene tomorrow, Alcorn and Prairie View for the championship. However, if Grambling wins, since this is their first game, if Grambling wins, then it's Grambling and Prairie View for the championship, and later, it will be Grambling and Prairie View. And if Grambling wins that game, hands Prairie View their first loss, then we'll be right back here tomorrow morning for a winner-take-all game. However, if Grambling wins, eliminates the Lady Braves, they play Prairie View later. If Prairie View wins that game, they win the SWAC championship this evening. So a few moving pieces. We had a lot more to talk about 24 hours ago. Not as much in this game. Glad you can join us. A warm, sultry afternoon here in Gulfport. The sun is out, 83 degrees. It feels like 90. And of course, it'll feel a little bit more than that on the field. This is the 4th meeting between these two teams this season. The pitching matchup, the Lady Braves will go with their number 3 starter, Tania Fletcher. She'll be opposed by second-team all-conference pitcher Asia Richard. Look at Grambling. They feature one team on the all-conference team, first-team all-conference shortstop Kadasia Collins. The Lady Braves do not have a player on the all-conference team. So you talk about teams that are hot. Lady Braves have won 11 of 14 coming into this game. These two teams faced each other recently in a makeup game at Alcorn State University, in which the Lady Tigers won 6-1. So these two teams know each other well, just played recently. And it should be interesting here as we have three teams. You look at Grambling and what they have done. Grambling State University, Pia Hall, the Lady Tigers beat FAMU 3-1, beat Bama State 4-0.
Ladies and gentlemen,
and they lost to Prairie View 5-2.
As we honor America with the playing,
we have our national anthem.
Would you please stand?
Here from Gulfport.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
When you join the HBCU family, you become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
Let's play ball. Is that a baseball deal or a softball deal? When you say let's play ball, I guess let's play ball, it's playing ball. And we're ready for some softball action as the Grambling Tigers are the designated home team. The Lady Braves have not been the designated home team yet in this tournament. So Grambling is the home team for this matchup. We have the throwing out of the first pitch. We've had that a couple of times here in this tournament. A nice toss to home plate. And I was asked to throw out the first pitch for a softball game, and I was sore for a week. I had to do some physical therapy afterwards. That's a true story. We welcome you back to Gulfport. Glad you can join us here as the Lady Tigers take the field. Look at Alcorn and what they've done. Back 2 years ago, they had four elimination games, and they wound up playing Alabama State for the championship and lost coming out of the loser's bracket. They played four games. This is their fourth game here, their fourth elimination game for the Lady Braves. Grambling State University, led by head coach Nakia Hall, former head coach at Alabama A&M. Had that A&M program on the rise. Taking an opportunity at Grambling. And of course, for the Lady Braves, Eugenia Fernandez, longtime assistant coach at Florida A&M. Her first season, her team making a deep run. Christian Edwards will lead it off. Here's the first pitch from Richard Strike called, and we are underway here in Gulfport. The winner moves on to take on Prairie View in the championship round. As far as softball here today, if the Lady Braves win, it'll be the only game today. We'll be back at you tomorrow. If Grambling wins, of course, they eliminate the Lady Braves. And later tonight, it will be Grambling and Prairie View for the championship. 1-1 the count. Here's the 1-1. Foul off, 1-2. Of course, if Grambling wins, they'll take on Prairie View. They're undefeated. And if Grambling wins that game later, then we'll have a winner-take-all tomorrow. Of course, if Prairie View wins, they win the championship. But the key is we would have more softball this evening if Grambling wins, because Grambling, this is just their first game. Of course, if the Lady Braves win, theoretically, it would be their third game today, and not feasible to play three games in one day. 1-2 the count to Christian Edwards. Edwards, 292 during the regular season, 375 in the postseason. His pitch just missed, 2-2. Ron Graham, the home plate umpire. Jason Jones at first. Leo Fleming at second, and Mario Belton at third. A four umpire crew here for the first time as we wind this down. The final three teams. Pitches high, 3-2. So umps at every base. Full count. Top of the first inning. There's the 3-2. A little flare in the shallow left. It's going to drop in for a base hit. Christian Edwards continues her solid work in the tournament. A leadoff single for the Lady Braves.
Edwards with a single in left field. Runner on first for the Braves. Hit it to the plate.
Christian Edwards,
number 13,
a little hobbled
second,
as she walks it off.
Perry.
First base coach Ambria Dorsey checking on her. Eugenia Fernandez asked from a distance, is she okay? And she is okay. Kennedy Terry, the left fielder, stands in for the Lady Braves. 438, 17th at bat in the tournament, 235 during the regular season. Leadoff is on for the Lady Braves. Fourth meeting between these teams. And Grambling won 2 out of 3. There's a ground ball to short. Throws a second for one over to first. Too late, a 6-4. Fielder's choice. Collins to second. Wells couldn't get it across in time, so a 6-4. Fielder's choice. And Terry on first with one out. The third baseman for the Lady Braves, Janice Wells. 247 during the year with a home run and 12 runs batted in. And for Janice Wells in the postseason, Janice Wells 167, 13th at bat. 1-0 the count, one out. Scoreless, Lady Braves with a leadoff single and a fielder's choice. Strike called. Major Richard, 11 wins, 11-5 during the regular season, 2.37 earned run average. 1-1 the count, one out. The pitch, check swing, a pitch is low. They don't check it first, 2-1. Second appearance in the SWAC tournament for Richard, 7 innings pitch, 2 strikeouts. Run on 6 hits. 1-2 the count. Pitch is low, runner going, and the throw and the tag too late. Stolen base for Terry. 2-2 the count.
3 balls, 1 strike.
Count is 3-1. For Terry, that's her 4th stolen base here in the SWAC tournament. Count is 3-1. The Lady Braves with a chance to strike first. Here's the 3-1. Ground ball up the middle. It's a base hit. Terry around third. Here's the throw home. Cut off. The throw in the second, and she is out, safe there. Everybody's safe. Lady Braves with the lead. Janice Wells, an RBI single, scoring Terry, taking second on the throw in. And the Lady Braves lead 1-0. Marche Hunt stands in. 1-0 Lady Braves. Solid hit up the middle. Throw home cut off. And the throw to second. Too late. Everybody's safe and the Lady Braves have the lead. Marche Hunt at the plate for the Lady Braves. 333 in the postseason, 16th at bat, 5 hits, 4 runs batted in. 1-1 the count, 1-0 Alcorn. Hunt fouls it straight back. Now it's 0-2. Lady Braves lost to Bama State 1-0 in this tournament. Eliminated FAMU, eliminated Bama State, eliminated Bethune-Cookman. 0-2 the count. Fly ball in the center. Caught in center for the second out. Maya Johnson hauls it in. Two out, runner at first. That was hard hit.
Correction, batting fifth is number one.
Kelsey Lockridge at the plate. See Lockridge, 167 in the postseason with a couple of runs batted in. During the season, Kelsey Lockridge, 279 during the year. This is outside, ball one. The last meeting between these two teams was on May the 3rd. In a game that had to be made up at Alcorn, which Grambling won 6-1. Here's a shot in a shallow right center. It's going to be caught in right. Side is retired as Deja Russell hauls it in. Lady Braves, a run on two hits, a fielder's choice, a stolen base, and they strand one. Glad you could join us here on the SWAC. We'll take a timeout. We'll be right back with the bottom of the first inning.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
You join the HBCU family. You become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
Welcome you back to Gulfport. 1-0, Lady Braves with the lead over Grambling. Tania Fletcher, the sophomore, will get the start. Fletcher, 2-5 during the season with a 6.02 earned run average. 9 starts, 28 strikeouts, 39 walks, and 45 and a third innings pitched. Caitlin Moore hit 310 during the regular season, stands in for the Lady Tigers. Pitch misses outside, ball one. Caitlin Moore just 43 with an RBI in the postseason for Grambling. 1-0 the count. Pitch misses outside. We started with 8. We're down to 3. Possibly down to a couple. All 3 teams remaining in the tournament from the Western Division. All the Eastern Division teams have been eliminated. Jackson State, Bethune-Cookman, Florida A&M, Alabama State have been eliminated. Teams left are from the Western Division. 3-0 the count to the leadoff hitter Moore. Bottom of the first inning. Lady Braves with an early lead. Pitch strike call, 3-1. As you can join us, I'm on the socials. Let me know what you think about the tournament, what you're seeing so far, what you're hearing so far about the 2023 SWAC Softball Tournament. I'm on Facebook, Charles Eppen. I'm on Twitter, Tall Man Radio. This next pitch strike call, we've had some feedback. And the count is full, 3-2. After falling behind, count is full, 3-2 to the leadoff hitter, Caitlin Moore. The 3-2. Slaps. And Moore slipped and thrown out at third. Janice Wells throws her out, tried to slap it to the left side, and her feet right from up under when she made that chop to third, an easy throw for Wells over. Base is empty, one out for first team all conference, Kadasia Collins. Pitch strike called. So Fletcher fell behind 3-0, made it 3-2, came back to get more, and now is ahead 1-0, 0-1 to Collins. 0-1, one out. Slap in the left center field, drops for a base hit. Collins, a single in the left center.
Collins with a slam to left field, runner on first.
So a one out single, Grambling with their first base runner. India Wells at the plate, the senior, hit 310 during the season with 21 runs batted in. Pitch is high, ball one. India Wells, no average, 10th at bat here in the postseason. 1-0 the count, one out, runner on, 1-0 Lady Braves. This pitch inside corner, 1-1 the count. One and one the count, one out. First inning, runner at first. 1-0. Lady Braves, one's on the board. Here's the 1-1. 2-1. Collins, 9 stolen bases and 10 attempts during the season. Hasn't stolen a base in this postseason. Here's the 2-1. Ground ball, a dribbler too deep, short, to throw to second, safe there. The infield single. The bang bang play, been close either way. But the Lady Braves, second baseman caught and dropped the ball.
At the plate is number 35.
So after a ground ball out off the bat of Moore, Collins and Wells have singled. 2-1, one out for the cleanup. Warren Irvin, the designated player. Pitch to Irvin, strike called. Irvin, 292 during the season with 6 runs batted in. Irvin, 286 in this tournament with 3 walks. Pitch from Fletcher inside, 1-1. 2-1, one out for the Lady Tigers. Lady Braves jumped out on top. RBI single by Janice Wells scored Christian Edwards. Here's the 1-1. Strike called, 1-2. 1-2 the count, one out. One for the Lady Tigers. Fletcher brings home the 1-2. The chase outside, stayed off of it, 2-2. Again, if the Lady Braves win this game, we'll reconvene tomorrow. If Grambling wins, since this is their first game, they eliminate the Lady Braves, and we'll be back tonight for Grambling and Prairie View. There's a little flare in the shallow left. It's going to drop in for a base hit. And they're loaded up for the Lady Tigers. 3 straight singles with 1 out. Collins, Wells, and now Irvin loads the bases for the Lady Tigers.
Tigers now with 1 out. Bases due.
Nia Jones. The plate for the Lady Tigers. Jones, the sophomore, 282 during the regular season with 15 runs batted in. Jones 1-11 in the postseason, 10th at bat. The pitch, riser high, ball one from Fletcher. So with one out, first team all conference shortstop, Kadasia Collins singled, India Wells singled, and Lauren Irvin singled. They're loaded up with one out, bottom one. Pitch inside corner, 1-1. 1-1 the count. Kia Hall thought that might have been a little inside. 1-1 the count. And she's asking, was that a ball? Oh, it's 2-0. Well, playing umpire yelled as if it was a strike. That's pitch strike called, and the count's 2-1. Maybe he yelled ball. Home plate umpire Ron Graham. I give the shout out to the umpires. Tough jobs, tough calls. Of course, we have replay. Here's the 2-1 inside, 3-1. There are two challenges that each coach has per game. If they lose the challenges, they're out of challenges. The Lady Braves in the game against Bama State didn't use their two until the last inning or two, and they won the challenges, and so therefore they kept them. 3-1, the count, bases loaded. There's a ground ball. Fletcher breaks it down. The throw home is there. Well, she broke it down enough. So the fielders, 1-2 out there.
Donigan down with 2 outs. Base is still due.
Fletcher broke it down, stayed with it, and made the throw. The catcher, Jillian Walters. And the pitch strike called. Well, she stayed with that. I mean, if she bobbled it even for a half a second, Grambling might have scored. But the 1-2 keeps the bases loaded. 2 out for Tatiana Robinson. Here's the pitch, a one hopper off of third. A run is in. It's an E5. It went off the heel of the glove of Janice Wells, and Grambling with the lead. E5.
At the plate is number one, Tanaya Johnson.
And went off the heel of Janice Wells' glove. A run is in. And the Tigers with their first run. They've tied this game 1-1 here in the first. Maya Johnson, the center fielder, stands in. This pitch, fastball, strike call. To Maya Johnson, 306 during the year with 18 runs batted in. To Maya Johnson, 143, eighth at bat here in the tournament. Here's the 0-1, riser is high, 1-1. Seventh player to bat in this inning. A run on 3 hits, an error, and a fielder's choice. 1-1 game. 1-1 the count, 2 out, bases loaded. Here's a shot foul down the right side. First base umpire Jason Jones had to skip out of the way. 1-2 the count, 2 out, bases loaded. Seventh player to bat in this inning. A run on 3 hits in air, fielder's choice in this inning. 1-2 from Fletcher. Stays alive. Again, I've been saying this entire tournament, hitters not getting cheated at the plate. They're getting their money's worth. They're extending at bats, fouling tough pitches, staying alive. We've seen it all tournament long. 1-2 here, 2 out, bases loaded. Just missed. Walters freeze framed it for the home plate umpire Ron Graham. 2-2 the count, 2 out, bases loaded. 1-1 game here in Gulfport. The losers eliminated. The winner will take on Prairie View. 2-2. Low full count. Full count 3-2, 2 out.
3-2, full count.
Big pitch here. Here's the 3-2. All four. Runners in.
All four. Runner to third for the Tigers. One run.
Bases loaded. Walk. 2-1 Grambling.
Is number five, Aja Russell.
Julian Walters coming out to kind of settle down Fletcher. Eighth batter in the inning. Two runs, three hits, a walk, an error, and a fielder's choice. Grambling with the 2-1 lead. One, GSU. Of course, in a game like this, an elimination game, you've got all your arms available. Lexa Viamoy, their number one starter's available. You got Parker, who pitched to Jim earlier, is available maybe for a short stint. So you've got some arms out there just to stay alive. But Grambling with the lead right now, 2-1. Bases remain loaded. For Deja Russell, the right fielder. Russell at 209 during the season. 125 in the postseason. 1-0. His pitch is low, 2-0. 2-1, Lady Braves trail here in the bottom of the first inning. 2-0 the count. The pitch, low, 3-0. Two to one, Grambling with the lead. Bases loaded, two out. 3-0 the count to the number eight hitter, Russell. Ball four, another walk, another run in. It's 3-1.
Ball four, running the first base. One run scored, base is still juiced.
Lady Braves bullpen will get busy. Assistant coach, former conference pitcher of the year, Ambria Dorsey. Will come out for the Lady Braves. Will she come out to pay a visit or will she make a change here? And there will be a pitching change coming up. So we'll take a break here. Pitching change coming up here as Tania Fletcher lasts two-thirds of an inning. We'll tell you about the next Lady Braves pitcher when we come back after this timeout.
Join the HBCU family. You become part of the tradition and bringing it with everything you do in the classroom and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those adding to it.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future. All in one.
Because the best way to honor our history is to make history.
Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
We're looking at Amaya Stevens in the first inning.
New lady on the mound.
Amaya Stevens. Second appearance, pitched two innings. The line for Fletcher right now, we'll give it to you in a moment, as the bases are loaded for Ayanna Fultz, the number nine hitter, strike called. The line right now for Fletcher, two-thirds of an inning, three runs, three hits, walked two, didn't strike out anyone, and all three runners on base are hers. Here's the pitch to Fultz, fouled straight back. Fultz during the season, 271 the average with two home runs and 20 runs batted in. Fultz, 125, ninth at bat with a hit in the tournament. Here's the 0-2, and this is gonna hook foul. Gahal chasing it for the Lady Braves, couldn't get there. The wind has been a factor, blowing in. Swirling. Tell you what, the conference made the right call last night in the Alcorn Bethune-Cookman game. There was lightning around, and even an hour or two after the game, down here it felt like a hurricane. This pitch misses outside. I mean, high winds, blowing rain, lightning, everything. no way we could have played the game last night with what we had going on. So the conference made the right call in calling the game last night, Alcorn and Bethune-Cookman. Again, the Lady Braves won earlier, 1-0. Here's the 1-2, a little shot to third, and the side is retired. But nine to the plate for Grambling. Three runs, three hits, an error, two walks, and three stranded. Lady Braves trail 3-1 with Howard, Hall, and Walters coming up after this 60-second timeout.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
Resume run. Hydration dropping. Rapid rehydration initiated. Unlock specialized blend of 5 electrolytes.
Rapid rehydration to get you back on your game. Gatorlyte, now available in powder and Gatorlyte Zero Sugar.
We welcome you back to Gulfport. Glad you can join us. Lady Braves, Grambling, GSU sit 9 to the plate. 3 runs, 3 hits. There's 2 walks. Fletcher is done. Lasted 2/3 of an inning. So the look on her is 3 runs, 3 hits, 2 walks, no strikeouts. As the Lady Braves come up with 6, 7, and 8 with McCurrier Howard, the designated player, leading it off.
Number 20, McCurrier Howard.
3-1, Grambling with the lead. Let's see if the Lady Braves can get it going here. They scored first. RBI single by Wells, scored Edwards. Kyria Howard at the plate for the Lady Braves. The freshman, she had 329 during the season. Pitch from Richard. Oh, 1-1. Howard, a good tournament, 357, 15th at bat, 5 hits, 4 runs batted in. 1-1 the count. Howard shot foul off to the right side. Lady Braves head coach Eugenia Fernandez, her first season. Took some time to get to know the players and vice versa. At times, she can be a very tough coach. She'll let you know when the tough practices are coming. Here's the 1-2. A little poke, dribbles, foul. But you talk to the players, they just love Coach Fernandez and just how she is. Has her team making a deep run in the postseason. Again, it just goes back to, you get in the postseason, you don't know what's going to happen. Here's a fly ball into the right center field. It's going to drop for a base hit. Oh, it gets by Wright. A single and an error. Single and an error. And Howard to second. It's a little flare into right center field. Johnson couldn't get there.
Braves no out, a runner on second.
It was backed up and right
at the plate
by Russell.
Micah Hall.
So Micah Hall stands in. So the Lady Braves are the runner in scoring position. Let's see how they play it here. Will they turn Hall loose or will she sacrifice? She's squaring up. Pitch is inside, a wild pitch. And Howard to third. Want to know the count? Want to know the count? Lady Braves a chance to get a run back here in the second inning. 3-1, Grambling with the lead. 1-0 the count. The pitch. Hit foul. Again, let's recap what could possibly happen. The Lady Braves win this game. It's their second game of the day. They eliminate Grambling. And they will play Prairie View, but it will be tomorrow because it will be the Lady Braves' third game of the day. They already beat Bethune-Cookman earlier today. This is their second game, and there's a little pop-up in foul territory. It's going to be caught at third. As Robinson hauls it in. One away. If Grambling wins this game, they eliminate the Lady Braves. And it'll be Grambling and Prairie View for the championship. And we will have another game today. Later, Grambling and Prairie View. Of course, if the Panthers win that game later, they win the championship. If Grambling wins, we'll come back here tomorrow. There's a pitch low, ball one, to Jillian Walters, the catcher. Look at this Lady Braves lineup. Three freshmen and a sophomore at the bottom of the lineup. 1-0 the count. Pitch from Richard. This is outside. 2-0. So we could have another game today, tonight, or we might reset. Come back at you tomorrow. We'll be here to bring you all the action. 2-0 the count. Swing and a miss. 2-1 the count. Walters 250 in this postseason. 2-1. Swing and a miss. Count is even. So after falling behind, Richard even the count. 2-2. Second inning, runner at third. One outside, full count. One count, 3-2, one out. 3-1, Lady Braves trail here in the top of the second inning. 3-1 pitch, popped up, fouling out of play. Count is full, 3-2. Three-two pitch. Popped up on the infield. So play it short. And Collins hauls it in. First team all conference shortstop, two away.
Runner on third. At the plate is number 22, Jemiah Cotton.
So to bring up Jemiah Cotton with the runner at third, two out. 3-1 Grambling, an opportunity for the Lady Braves to get a run. Mr. Cotton, a dribbler back to the pitcher, and the inning is over. The Lady Braves stranded a runner at third. She was there with one out, left stranded, a hit, an error, and one stranded. We played an inning and a half. 3-1 Grambling with the lead. Top of the lineup, bottom two for Grambling. After this, timeout.
Hydration dropping. Rapid rehydration initiated. Unlock specialized blend of 5 electrolytes.
Rapid rehydration to get you back on your game. Gatorlight, now available in powder and Gatorlight Zero Sugar.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
We go to the bottom of the second inning. Three teams left in this 2023 championship, all from the Western Division. Number one seed in the West, the number two seed in the West, the number four seed in the West, still alive. First pitch strike called to Caitlin Moore, grounded to third her last time up. We are underway here in the bottom of the second inning. 3-1, Lady Tigers. The walks hurt. There's a ground ball to second. And the quick flip, one out, is Cotton. Throws out Moore.
At the plate is
20. Taniah Fletcher got the start for the Lady Braves, lasted two-thirds of an inning. And for the Lady Braves, Maya Stevens trying to keep Grambling right where they are. This pitch strike called, long inning effort here for her. I mean, you're in a situation, an elimination game, you've got most of your arms available. Try to keep the score within reach. 0-1 the count. This pitch misses outside. Count is 1-1, one out. We've seen, you know, pitchers get off the slow starts and coaches kind of let them work through it. This pitch just missed outside. 2-1. 2-1 the count, one out. The 2-1. Foul off to the right side. Count is 2-2. We'll be right back at you on the SWAC Digital Network in a couple of weeks. The 2023 SWAC Baseball Tournament in Atlanta coming up. Here's the 2-2. Time called. For all the latest news, following Southwestern Athletic Conference athletics, go to swac.org. We're heading to the ATL in a couple of weeks. Should be a lot of fun. A lot of alums in the city of Atlanta for all of our SWAC schools, all 12, so should be a lot of fun. Here's a 2-2, off speed, fouled off. On the Western side, you've got Grambling who's played well, Prairie View, Texas Southern. UAPB has played well of late, trying to keep themselves in the conversation. A one hopper to second, and India Wells.
Tigers now with two out.
Throws out Collins, two away.
Is 00, India Wells.
India Wells, an infield single her last time up. 3-1, Grambling with the lead. Bases empty, two out. Bottom of the second inning. Pitch strike called. Been a busy time for the SWAC office. All the different championships over the last month or so. The commissioner talked about it. Kind of a busy time. Pitch misses outside. Get a little bit of a break. But the conference offices are in Birmingham, a short 167-mile trip to the east to Atlanta. Here's the 1-1. Shot up the middle, and it's a base hit. Right center field. Wells 2-for-2.
Wells with a screamer to center field. Runner now on first. Tigers with two out.
Two out. Tigers have a base runner. They stranded the bases loaded in the first, even though they got three in. They'll bring up the cleanup, the designated player, Lauren Irvin, singled her last time up. Two out. Trying to lay down a bunt. kind of stuck the bat out. She's in for a strike. Oh, she, right, she didn't bunt at it. 0-1 the count. Inside, runner going, and the throw is high and too late. Stolen base for Wells. Well, India Wells, during the season, stole 38 bases in 42 attempts. Stolen base here, runner in scoring position. Here's the 1-1. Shot foul down the left side. Count is 1-2 again. Let's recap the action. We started with Alcorn and Bethune-Cookman. Lady Braves eliminated Bethune-Cookman. This is their second game of the day. If the Lady Braves win this game, they eliminate Grambling, and we will be done for today, because if you play it out, it will be the third game for the Lady Braves if you play it today. But that won't take place if the Lady Braves win this game. We'll be done here today, and we'll be back tomorrow for Alcorn Prairie View if the Lady Braves win this game. But if Grambling wins, this is their first game of the day, then later tonight we'll have Grambling and Prairie View tonight. Here's the pitch low. And of course, Grambling Prairie View, Panthers are undefeated, got to knock them out twice. We'll have one game tonight if that happens. Of course, if Grambling wins this game, if Grambling wins tonight, then we'll be back at you tomorrow for a winner take all. 2-2 the count, two out. Shot in the left center. It's a base hit. Wells around third. She'll score. And Grambling with a 4-1 lead. RBI single by Irvin. Scores Wells, who singled and stole a base. 4-1, Lady Tigers.
Number three, Nia Jones.
That'll bring up the catcher, Nia Jones. Fielder's choice her last time up. So after the Lady Braves jumped out 1-0, Grambling with three in the first, one here in the second. Strike call by Amaya Stevens. In for Fletcher. 4-1 GSU. Here in the bottom of the second inning. A run on two hits and a stolen base. This pitch misses outside. One and one the count. One and one the count, two out. Ground ball to third. And a good play over at third by the Lady Braves third baseman. He's Wells, and the side is retired. Grambling gets a run on two hits, and they strand their fourth runner. Two complete here in Gulfport, Mississippi. Elimination game, Prairie View in the championship. Who will join them? Right now, Grambling with a 4-1 lead, top of the third inning. We'll be right back after this timeout.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one.
Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
Hydration dropping. Rapid rehydration initiated. Unlock specialized blend of five electrolytes.
Rapid rehydration to get you back on your game. Gatorlyte, now available in powder and Gatorlyte Zero Sugar.
Welcome back to Gulfport, Mississippi. Glad you can join us. We've had a little bit of everything. Heat, humidity, rain, lightning, heavy rain. For a brief minute, it was a little bit of a cool spell. For a brief minute. But that's what you get on the Gulf Coast this time of year. 4-1. There's a bunt foul. The Lady Braves trying to generate some offense here in the third inning. Christian Edwards leads it off, single the last time up. Lady Braves with two hits. Grambling with four hits. Grambling's out hit the Lady Braves 4-2. Grambling leads 4-1. Top of the third inning. Lady Braves did not have one player on the all-conference team. For a team that made a push down the stretch to get in the top four. Foul it off her foot. There was a time during the year in which the Lady Braves were struggling a bit, but they found their groove. They played a game at Texas Southern, which they lost. They felt good about that game, and it was kind of a turning point. And I've heard coaches say sometimes an L doesn't necessarily stand for a loss. It can be a learning experience. Lost third game of a series at Texas Southern, kind of turned it around. They had the right teams coming up too. They had Southern coming up. There's a ground ball foul. Well, the schedule kind of worked in their favor as well. They had Southern coming in, and they swept Southern. In that third game, Lady Braves were up 5-0. Southern tied it up in a walk-off home run by Marche Hunt, the seventh inning. But the Lady Braves in the tournament, they're making the most of it. Here's a fly ball to short. Collins hauls it in, one away. You look at Grambling, they're number four in the league in hitting at 275. They're number one in the conference in pitching, 3.09 earned run average, number one in the league. There's a slap foul. So Grambling's a team. From a pitching perspective, slow things down. Not gonna lie, I came in thinking that we might, as we get deeper into the tournament, have some high scoring games, but that hasn't been the case. There's a slap down the left side, and playing off the line is Moore. Two away.
Two out now for the Braves. At the plate is number 11. Denise Whale.
And that is five in a row set down by Richard. Second team all-conference pitcher for the Lady Tigers. The first pitch to Wells, an RBI single, scoring Edwards in the first. One for one with an RBI. 1-0 the count. Grambling with a 4-1 lead. This pitch misses. Two and all the count. Grambling with three in the first, one in the second. They lead 4-1. This pitch is high and outside, 3-0. Three and oh the count, two out. 4-1 Grambling. Here's the 3-0. All four.
First
walk issued by Richard.
Marche
Hunt. Fly to center her last time up. Two out, runner at first. 4-1, Grambling. Hunt ground ball to third on a hop. Inning over. Hard hit. Right at Robinson, a walk and one left. Lady Braves have stranded three. Two and a half complete, 4-1, Grambling. Robinson, Johnson, and Russell, 6, 7, and 8 coming up after this timeout. We'll be right back.
We are a limitless future.
opening new doors, new ways, new everything. For your past, present, and future. All in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
Parker. Lady Braves have made a pitching change. Kiri Parker, the third Lady Braves pitcher in the game for Alcorn. So Parker follows Stevens, who followed the starter Fletcher, who went two-thirds of an inning. So Eugenia Fernandez just trying to find a way to slow Grambling down a bit while the bats to get going here. Well, Tatiana Robinson at the plate. So one run given up by Stevens. Three given up by Fletcher, who lasted two-thirds of an inning. 1-1 the count to Robinson. Reached on an error last time up. Swing and a miss. Count is 1-2. Charles Edmond, glad you can join us. It feels like 90 degrees here on the Gulf Coast. 1-2 the count. 4-1 Grambling. A ground ball to short. And the throw across low and the scoop. And a good play all the way around on the short hop. Lockridge. Marche Hunt with the extension.
Tiger with one out.
One out.
Headed to the plate, number one, Tamaya Johnson.
So right now the Lady Braves, through three innings, have gone through three pitchers. The only arm really they have left is their number one, Alexa Viamoy. 4-1, Grambling. So high ball one to Maya Johnson, a bases loaded walk. Her last time up made it 2-1. Here's the 1-0. Low, 2-0. The count. This pitch strike called. Kiri Parker, 1-1 in the tournament. She has pitched 13 2/3 innings in her two appearances. Here's the 2-1. Strike call, 2-2. The count, one out. 4-1 Grambling. Day four of the 2023 softball tournament. And a ground ball to third. To second. And the throw is across for the second out. As Cotton
at the plate is number five,
throws out Johnson and Deja Russell. She had a bases loaded walk to make it 3-1. Grambling added a run in the second, make it 4-1. They're up in the third with the bases empty. That's high ball one. 1-0 the count. Bottom three. Count is 1-1. Again, just for those who are just joining us, we're down to three teams left. We started with eight. We're down to three. This pitch strike called. It's an elimination game. Prairie View awaits the winner of this game. If the Lady Braves win this game, to avoid a third game today, we'll be back at you tomorrow. Here's the 1-2. Misses outside. If Grambling wins, this is just their first game of the day, then we'll be back tonight at 6 o'clock for Grambling and Prairie View. Of course, if Prairie View wins that game, they win the championship. Here's a one-hopper back to Parker, and the throw is low. A fastball low, but out. Side is retired. So 1-2-3 inning for Parker. Three complete, 4-1. Grambling with the lead. Lady Braves will have 5, 6, and 7 coming up. Lockridge, Howard, and Hall. After this from Gulfport. We'll be right back.
We are a limitless future. Opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future. All in one.
Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
When you join the HBCU family, you become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
We welcome you back to Gulfport, Mississippi. Glad you can join us. Lady Braves jumped out 1-0, and then Grambling with 3 in the first, 1 in the second. Lady Braves up in the fourth. 4-1. Kelsey Lockridge at the plate. Fly to right her last time up. Facing Richard. First pitch misses outside. 1-0 the count. 4-1. Grambling. Here's the 1-0. Ground ball foul. Shania Fernandez with an effort. Gonna go down and get that. Eugenia Fernandez, longtime assistant softball coach at Florida A&M. When the Lady Braves played Florida A&M, I asked her after the game, you know, does she have any butterflies facing your former team, a place where you were an assistant under a really, really good softball coach? She said there's a little bit of butterflies until the game started, and then she had to get to work. 1-2 the count. She puts her team through the paces. 1-2 the count. I was talking with Coach Hall. I mean, kind of the same way. You know, it's got the intensity. It's got that passion, got that love of her players. And Grambling players really loose a lot of the times. Here's the 2-2. Diving stop at short. The long throw is there. One out. Collins, all-conference shortstop, with the play and the extension at first by Fultz. I think that's what did it. And look how deep in the hole that is. Pounce up, you gotta make a strong enough throw. And let's see here, we're looking at, they're not gonna challenge it. Oh yeah, she is out. That's a good call. She's out. If there was a challenge, she probably would have lost that. Eugenia Fernandez does not challenge. One out, Howard at the plate. It's the 0-1, just misses one and one. One and one the count. Top of the fourth inning. Lady Braves rally and win this game. It'll be the final game of the day. If Grambling wins, we'll have another game at 6. This pitch, swing and a miss. And we lay out that first scenario because this is the second game that Alcorn has played today. Gonna play a third game. Here's the 1-2. This is outside. 2-2 the count. One out, fourth inning. Grambling 4, Alcorn 1, top of the fourth inning. The 2-2. Off speed, misses. Count is full, 3-2. Hour and 3 minute game so far. Here's the 3-2, a foul off to the right side. Of course, the winner of this tournament will punch their ticket to the regionals. Last year, Prairie View won it, played in the Oklahoma regional. Here's the 3-2. Two out.
Why your treatment so encyclopedia make me feel so undictionary?
Two out.
Don't know why your treatment so encyclopedia make me feel so undictionary. Ask the plate at number
2 out.
Micah Hall.
Micah Hall, the right fielder at the plate. Fly to third her last time up. Pitch misses outside, ball 1. That's the first strikeout by Richard. 1-0 the count, 4-1, Grambling with the lead. 3 in the first, 1 in the second. Hall popped up mile high left side, and it's caught at third. The side is retired in foul territory. Robinson hauls it in. Side is retired.
And that'll wrap it up
for the top of the fourth inning. Bottom four coming up. 9-1-2 Fultz Moore. All-conference shortstop, Kadeja Collins. Coming up after this, timeout from Gulfport.
We are a limitless future. Opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future. All in one.
Because the best way to honor our history is to make history.
Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
People who come to Cricket stay with Cricket. Like one of our favorite customers, Michelle.
I started my own app company, and with Cricket, I'm able to answer calls from my engineers and investors and know my signal's going to be great. If I had to describe Cricket in 2 words, they would be reliable and affordable.
5G boss mode activate. Smile, you're on Cricket.
Here in Gulfport, bottom of the fourth inning. 9-1-2 coming up for Grambling. Aya Fultz, Caitlin Moore, Kadeja Collins. Facing Kiri Parker, the third pitcher for the Lady Braves. Second inning of work for Parker. She set him down in order in the third. Grambling up in the bottom of the fourth. Fultz fly to third, her last time up. Aya Fultz from Vicksburg, Mississippi. Pitch from Parker, right down the middle. We're underway. Lady Braves led 1-0. On a wild pitch. There's the 0-1. She's outside. Grambling with three in the first inning. With one out, Collins single, Wells an infield single, Irvin with a single. 1-2 fielder's choice, then an error. There's a two hopper to short, and the thrower across is there. Well, shortstops have been busy. The Lady Braves, Kelsey Lockridge, throws out Fultz.
At the plate is number 10, Caden Moore.
An error by third tied the game, then a bases loaded walk, back-to-back bases loaded walks made it 3-1 in the first inning. And in the second inning, with two out, India Wells a single to right center, a stolen base, and then an RBI single by Irvin scored Wells to make it 4-1. This pitch strike called. Count is 1-1. One and one to count, one out. 4-1. Grambling a line shot to third. Janice Wells has been busy at third.
12 for the Tigers. At the plate is number 20, Kadasia Collins.
So it'll bring up all SWAC shortstop Kadasia Collins. 1-for-2, single to left center. And grounded to second. This pitch strike called again, and we'll say it throughout. Elimination game. This is the fourth for the Lady Braves. If the Lady Braves win this game, they eliminate Grambling, and to avoid playing a third game today, because the Lady Braves played earlier, there's a fly ball in the shallow right center, caught at second, side is retired. If the Lady Braves win this game today, we'll be done for the day, because the Lady Braves will not be forced to play a third game today. If Grambling wins, since this is their first game, we'll have a game later. Right now, Grambling with a 4-1 lead as we go to the bottom of the inning. We'll take a break here. We'll be right back after this. Timeout.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
People who come to Cricket stay with Cricket. Like one of our favorite customers, Michelle.
I started my own app company, and with Cricket, I'm able to answer calls from my engineers and investors and know my signal's going to be great. If I had to describe Cricket in two words, they would be reliable and affordable.
5G boss mode, activate. Smile, you're on Cricket.
Top of the fifth inning at the plate for the Braves is number 12, Jillian Walter.
Top of the fifth inning, Jillian Walters will lead it off. Wide to shorter last time up. Swing and a miss, we're underway. Top of the fifth inning. 4-1, Lady Braves trail. Glad you could join us. Charles Edmond here in Gulfport. Nice little breeze is blowing. A little warm. A nice breeze at the moment. Tell you what, a lot of rain, lightning, wind here last night. The SWAC made the exact right call in calling off the game last night. I mean, when I left here last night, there's a fly ball in the shallow right center, mile high in the air, and it's caught in center. One away as Tamiah Johnson hauls it in.
One out for the Braves.
Gonna bring up the number 9 hitter, Jamiah Cotton.
At the plate is number 22, Jamiah Cotton.
Cotton grounded back to the pitcher last time up. High winds, heavy rain for about a good hour. Even though this field drains well, there's just no way with the lightning and the wind, there's no way you could have played. So the SWAC did the smart thing. Halt the game, pick it up. We started at 10 o'clock this morning. Lady Braves won 1-0, eliminating Bethune-Cookman. Here's the 1-0. This is outside. Great ball game. A wild pitch scored the only run for the Lady Braves, and it held up. 2-0 the count, one out. A 2-0. Strike called. 2-1. We started with 8. We're down to 3. After this game, we'll be down to 2. This pitch low and inside. 2-1 the count. This is the 4th elimination game for the Lady Braves. After losing 1-0 to Bama State, they eliminated FAMU, Bama State, and earlier today, Bethune-Cookman. Here's a 3-1, shot in the center, and this ball's gonna drop for a base hit. So Cotton, a single to center with one out. Hit that one hard. Batter played, say, a little bit beyond medium depth, so just dropped it in front of the center fielder, Johnson. So top of the lineup for the Lady Braves, Christian Edwards, 1-for-3. Single, fly to short in second. One out, one on. Edwards taking it the other way, and it's fair down the right field line. Cotton around second, motors into third. And she will score it on RBI triple. By Kennedy Terry. Scoring Cotton, and it's 4-2. Lady Braves cut the deficit to 4-2.
And of course, headed to the plate is number 13, Kennedy Terry.
Kennedy Terry at the plate. 4-2. So 4-2, the Lady Braves trail. They get a run, a single and a triple. All right, so Kennedy Terry at the plate. 4-2. Pitch misses ball one. Lady Braves up in the 5th. Trying to climb back after leading 1-0, trailing 4-1, now 4-2. Here's the 1-0. This is outside. Two and oh the count. The 2-0. Strike call, 2-1. So a single and a triple. 4-2, Grambling. Again, if the Lady Braves rally and win this game, it'll be the final game of the day. If Grambling wins, swing and a miss. 2-2 the count. We'll be back at you at 6. Of course, if Alcorn wins, I want them to play their 3rd game of the day. 2-2 the count, one out. 4-2 Grambling. Just missed. Count is full, 3-2. 3-2 the count.
3-2, full count.
Here's the pitch. Chopper to third. The throw over out there, and the throw home is too late. Run is in, and it's 4-3. So 4-3, the throw home dropped. A good job by Terry. Looked the runner back to third. really not much you could do with that. I mean, if you've got a lead, once that third baseman commits to throwing it across, not much you can do. So the Lady Braves get a run, and it's 4-3. So a couple in for the Lady Braves. Well, Denise Wells, 1-for-1 with a walk. So the Lady Braves, 2 runs, 2 hits. It's 4-3. There's a foul off to the left side. Count is 0-2. So after trailing 4-1, the Lady Braves with a couple here in the fifth. Four to three in the fifth inning. This foul straight back. Count is 0-2. With Janice Wells. A year in a row, we've been here in Gulfport. The 2023 SWAC Softball Tournament. This pitch misses outside. Tournament the last few years has had a couple of different stops. Irondale, Alabama, as well as on the campus of Alabama State. Here's the 1-2. Ground ball, dribbler, foul. Speaking of Irondale, one of the one of the employees who kept up the fields there. There were two fields, by the way, at the Irondale facility. Raquel Thompson sent a text checking out the coverage. Count is 1-2. Two out. This is outside, 2-2. Appreciate the comments. Appreciate your comments on the coverage of the 2023 SWAC Softball Tournament. I'm on the socials. Facebook, Charles Edmond. Twitter, Tall Man Radio. Here's a 2-2. Foul off the mask. Oh, lovely. Catcher Jones. Oh, and that caught her. Looks like she's okay. Well, that was a hard, vicious foul straight back off mask. Says she's okay. The catcher, Nia Jones. Two and two, two out. 4-3. Grambling with the lead. Here's the 2-2. Off speed. That was a 3-2 pitch. Just misses. Is it 3-2? 3-2. Okay, so they had it right. She thought it was ball four. So the count is full, 3-2. 3-2 the count. Full count. Here's the 3-2. Ball four. Tying run at first.
All four running the first for the Braves.
And Marche Hunt stands in. Tying run at first. I think Eugenia Fernandez is going to bring in a pinch runner here. So Marche Hunt at the plate. And we have a pinch runner, I think Kamaya Dillon will pinch run for Wells. So we'll see how Eugenia Fernandez plays this. You got a very good contact hitter in Hunt. She's 0-for-2 today. Will there be some two-out running here? The pitch, and on a fly ball in the left field all the way to the wall. Milling around third. She's going to be waved around. She'll score, and the Lady Braves have tied it up. Dylan, the pinch runner, scores all the way from first. And it's a 4-4 game. As Marche Hunt, an RBI double, scoring the pinch runner, Dylan. So the Lady Braves with three in the fifth inning. And it's a 4-4 game here in Gulfport. So a 4-4 game with Kelsey Lockridge coming to the plate. We might have another pinch runner here. Sarah Kennedy will pinch run for Hunt. Well, that was hard hit by Marche Hunt. And now Coach Hall will make a pitching change. So we'll step aside here for 60 seconds. The Lady Braves with three in the fifth inning have tied it up at four. Go ahead, run at second. We'll take a timeout. We'll be right back after this.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways. Everything. We are past, present, and future. All in one.
Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet. Honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
So a pitch runner, Sarah Kennedy at second, and you're looking at Aaron Gibbs on the mound for Grambling. Seven innings pitched, three strikeouts and a walk. There's the pitch, swing and a miss. So Richard, 4 2/3 innings pitched. Four runs, four hits. This pitch misses outside. Count is 1-1. Gibbs, her second appearance in the tournament. 1-1, two out. Well, Grambling. And a 4-1 lead. The Lady Braves chip away at it. 4-4. Pitch high. An RBI double by Marche Hunt scores the pinch runner Dylan, who walked all the way from first. And then Sarah Kennedy pinch ran for Hunt, and she's at second. Count is 2-1. Ground ball to third, and the throw across is there. Side is retired, but the Lady Braves plate three, and the top of the fifth inning.
Wrap it up at three runs.
Three hits, runs, three hits, and one stranded.
Going into the bottom of the fifth.
We'll take a break here. Bottom of the fifth inning. And the middle of the lineup coming up for Grambling. Right after this, timeout.
Resume run. Hydration drop. Rapid rehydration initiated. Unlock specialized blend of 5 electrolytes.
Rapid rehydration to get you back on your game. Gatorlyte, now available in powder and Gatorlyte Zero Sugar.
People who come to Cricket stay with Cricket. Like one of our favorite customers, Michelle.
I started my own app company, and with Cricket, I'm able to answer calls from my engineers and investors and know my signal's going to be great. If I had to describe Cricket in two words, they would be reliable and affordable.
5G Boss Mode activate. Smile, you're on Cricket.
A happy Lady Braves dug out. They rallied from 4-1 down to tie it up at 4. I'm Charles Edmond. Welcome back to Gulfport, Mississippi. Grambling, we're in the bottom of the fifth inning.
Bottom of the fifth inning, at the plate is 0-0, India Wells.
India Wells, 2-for-2 with a stolen base. Wells followed by Irvin and Jones. Part of the lineup for Grambling. Henry Parker, the third Lady Braves pitcher. And the offense has come around. New game, 4-4, bottom of the fifth inning. Again, if the Lady Braves win this game, we're done for the day. If Grambling wins this game, we'll have another game later. There's a shot in the shallow right, and it's going to be caught. Nice running catch. The wind knocked it down a bit, and Michael Hall with the running catch, one away. Let's take a look at it here. Well, the wind knocked it down, and Hall, good extension, good speed. The speed got her there. Lauren Irvin at the plate. Here's the pitch, low. Second inning of work for Kiri Parker. Parker, the number two starter for the Lady Braves. 1-0 the count, 4-4 game in the fifth. Strike called, 1-1. Hour and a half game here in Gulfport. 4-4, bottom five. 2-1 to count. Another good crowd here. Day four started on Tuesday morning. Started with 8 teams. We're down to 3. And after this game, we'll be down to 2. 3-1 to count. The number one seed in the East, Lady Hornets, eliminated yesterday. All the teams in the Eastern Division have been eliminated. Here's the 3-1. Slap foul down the left side. Count is full. 3-2. The count, one out. 4-4 game. Bottom of the fifth inning. Chopper to Parker. Underhand toss, close but out. Irvin hustling down the line. Two out.
Number three, Nia Jones.
Nia Jones hit with fielder's choice and grounded to third. Parker has set down the first five she has faced, her second inning of work. Strike called. I think, you know, obviously with the game last night being called, Lady Braves had a chance to get rest because it was their second game of the day yesterday. 0-1. Foul off to the right side. Count is 0-2. So Parker, one pitch away from getting out of this fifth inning. The Lady Braves will have 6, 7, and 8 coming up in the sixth inning. This pitch misses outside. Count is 1-2. Bottom of the fifth inning. We're tied at 4. Here's the 1-2. Low and inside, 2-2. Two and two the count, two out, fifth inning, 4-4 game. Here's the 2-2. Good foul to the right side again. This is the second game of the day for the Lady Braves. If they win this game, they'll eliminate Grambling. And to avoid playing a third game today, we'll just come back tomorrow. It'll be Alcorn and Prairie View if the Lady Braves win this game. Because this is Grambling's first game of the day, if they win this game, they eliminate Alcorn and we'll play later. Grambling and Prairie View. Pitches high, full count. Full count, 3-2 in the fifth. She's jammed, popped up. Parker hauls it in. Side is retired. We go to the sixth inning, 6, 7, and 8. Howard, Hall, and Walters coming up after this 1 minute timeout. Come on back, folks.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
In the top of the sixth inning, Makaria Howard struck out her last time up. And the count is 2-0. Both starting pitchers are gone. Lady Braves are on their third pitcher. It's the 2-0. High, 3-0. Aaron Gibbs, the second Lady Tiger pitcher. 3-0 the count. 4-4 game in the sixth inning. Here's the 3-0. High and inside, ball four, go ahead run. Is at first.
Ball four, run in the first for the Braves.
Pinch runner coming up for the Lady Braves.
At the plate is number 7, Michael Hall.
All at the plate, but we'll have a pinch runner here. The go-ahead run is at first base. We're waiting for the pinch runner to come in. Who will they go with here? There we go. Kiri Parker.
Pinch runner is number 3.
She could have her hands all over this game. She's on the mound. She represents the go-ahead run at first. There's a bunting situation and a good one. Fielded at third, the throw across is there. Well, that was a tough, tricky bunt that was fielded. Good speed by Hall, hustling down the line. Let's take a look at that. Let's see how tricky of a bunt that is. A catcher with the field. He had to turn and make the good throw. So 2-3 sacrifice. So bottom of the lineup, Jillian Walters 0-for-2, fly to short and center. Has a chance to give the Lady Braves the lead. a foul straight back. Again, if the Lady Braves win this game, they eliminate Grambling. And to avoid Alcorn playing another game today, we'll just come back tomorrow. If Grambling wins, with this being their first game, they eliminate Alcorn and we'll play tonight at 6, Grambling and Preview. Too close to call right now, 4-4. Pitch misses outside. Count is 1-1. 1-1 the count, one out. Lady Braves were down 4-1. They were up 1-0 and down 4-1. Now a 4-4 game. Pitch strike call of the outside corner. Maya Cotton, 1-2 in the on deck circle. 1-2 the count, one out. 4-4 game in the sixth. Go ahead, run is at second. As the pitch misses outside. 2-2 the count, one out. It's the 2-2. Ground ball to third. The throw across is there, and the throw across is thrown away. Miscommunication. Lady Braves with the lead. So miscommunication at third. The ball sailed away, and the Lady Braves have the lead. Grambling executed there, the throw across, that was fine. Then the throw from Fultz. Nobody home. Lady Braves have the lead. E6. That was a shortstop's ball on the coverage. So the Lady Braves have the lead 5-4 after trailing 4-1. The Lady Braves have the lead.
Braves now 2 out, 1 run scored at the plate of number 21.
Alana Belton will pinch hit for Cotton. There's the pitch, swing and a miss. So the Lady Braves have the lead. The Lady Braves hang on and win this game. We're done for the day. It'll be all Alcorn and Preview if this holds up, but still too early to tell. Lady Braves are battle back and have the lead. 1-1 the count to the number 9 hitter, Felton. On the throw across to third, there was nobody there. Wanted to get that one. 1-1 the count. There's a foul off to the left side. You know, you often wonder about those. It's got to be executed perfectly, because if not, the run would score. Just as a softball fan, you see that throw across in that situation all the time. Are you better off holding it? From a softball perspective, here's the 1-2, a ground ball to third. High throw! And E5, two base error. Now the runner all the way to third, and here's the throw, and she's going to be out at third. Trying to stretch a single in an error into a two-base error. Eugenia Fernandez didn't like that. As Felton, it was an E5, and then, as you can see, the tag, yep, definitely out. But the Lady Braves have the lead. 5-4 here in the bottom of the sixth inning. Coming up for Grambling, we'll take a timeout. We'll be right back. Lady Braves have rallied from 4-1 down to lead 5-4. We'll be right back at the bottom of the sixth.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
join the HBCU family. You become part of the tradition and bringing it with everything you do in the classroom and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those adding to it.
Five-4, Alcorn with the lead. We go to the bottom of the sixth inning. The number two starter, Keery Parker, the third Lady Braves pitcher in this game. In the bottom of the sixth. Ball low, ball one. We are underway. Bottom six. Well, the Lady Braves, well, they're used to these one-run games here in the tournament. Tatiana Robinson reached on an air, grounded to short. This pitch strike called. Third straight one-run tilt for the Lady Braves in the tournament. Beat Bama State in extra inning 6-5. Beat Bethune-Cookman 1-0. And they've rallied from 4-1 down to lead 5-4. The ground ball to short. The throw across is there. Solid throw. One away. Lockridge throws out Robinson, 6-3.
At the plate is number one, Tamaya Johnson.
Tamaya Johnson, a bases loaded walk, and a ground ball to second. Again, Keery Parker, third inning of work. Third pitcher for the Lady Braves. Right now the Lady Braves down to their number one starter, Alexa Viamoy. 5-4. Here's the 1-0. Strike call. I mean, you got to look at it this way. If you win this game, then you don't play again until tomorrow. So you got your number one arm to go with. Here's the 1-1. Foul off to the right side. Of course, for Grambling, if they win this game, they've got to come back and play Prairie View for the championship. Count is 1-2. 1-2 the count, one out. Here's the 1-2. Misses outside. Of course, Prairie View A&M arrived here a short time ago. I don't know if there are any players on the bus or not. Of course, if the Lady Braves win, they don't have to play until tomorrow. Here's the 2-2, off speed, high, full count. Of course, if Grambling wins, they'll be playing next. So maybe the players are on the bus just checking it out on their iPads or tablets. Full count, 3-2, one out. Just foul straight back. Of course, the Panthers head coach Vernon Bland, second straight tournament championship game appearance. Team last year started 0-19 and won it. Some off-the-field stuff really emotionally had to deal with in August. And here they are again, playing for the championship. A one out walk to Tamaya Johnson. Time running first.
With one out. At the plate is number five,
Deja Russell. 0-1 with a walk. Her bases loaded walk made it 3-1. Right now, 5-4, the Lady Braves. If the pitch is low, ball one. 1-0 the count. Here's the 1-0. This is low. 2-0. Tying run at first. Go ahead, run at the plate. Bottom of the lineup. Anna Fultz, number 9 hitter on deck. 2-1 the count, one out, runner at first, 5-4 Lady Braves. This pitch strike call, runner going, and the tag is too late. Stolen base for Johnson. Tying run at second. Let's take a look at it here. From behind home plate, got a good start, good jump. Throw across from Walters. Yep, she got in. Here's the pitch. Tried to bunt at it and missed it. 2-2. 2-2 the count. Runner at second. Tying run at second. One out. 5-4 Lady Braves. They rallied from 4-1 down to take the lead, but Grambling has the runner in scoring position here in the sixth inning. 2-2 the count. Here's the 2-2. Fly ball down the left side, and it could not be caught at short. The ball was fading away from the shortstop Lockridge. Left it all out there, though. Wynn pushed that from right to left. Count remains 2-2, one out. Five, four, Lady Braves. Here's the pitch. A little dribbler foul to the right side. Try to poke that to right. Tobiah Johnson with a one out walk. Just stole second. Number eight hitter Russell has a 2-2 count. One out. Bottom of the sixth inning. Lady Braves with a 5-4 lead. Here's the pitch. Pop up. Oh, and could not be caught by Walters. Again, a lot of spin. A lot of left spin. Good effort by Walters. So a couple of pop-ups could not be caught in foul territory. Count is 2-2. Bottom of the sixth inning. One run lead for the Lady Braves. The pitch. Pitch is high. Full count. Full count, 3-2. One out, runner at second. 3-2 pitch. Foul off to the left side. It's saying in all tournament, these hitters are not getting cheated at the plate. They're taking their cuts, taking full advantage of the opportunities here. 3-2 the count. One out, runner at second. 5-4 Lady Braves. Pitch from Parker. Ground ball, Parker bobbles it, picks it up, and throws her out. Two away. Now to bring up the first baseman, Yana Foltz.
Now with two out, a runner on second. At the plate is number 15, Anaya Foltz.
Anaya Foltz at the plate. Foltz, the senior from Vicksburg. She's 0 for 2, grounded to short, fly to third. Pitch to Foltz. This is outside, ball one. We have the top of the lineup coming up for Grambling if Foltz gets on. Alcorn 5, Grambling 4, bottom of the sixth inning. 1-0. Strike call, 1-1. During the season, Foltz hit 271, 20 runs batted in, a couple of home runs, 8 doubles, so she can make contact. 1-1, low. 2-1 to count. One one to Foltz. Pitch from Parker. Popped up. Foul territory. Is there a play? Yes. Jillian Walters hauls it in, and the side is retired. A couple of pop-ups in foul territory the Lady Braves couldn't get. But right there, Walters hauls it in for the third out, and we go to the seventh inning. 5-4. Lady Braves, they've rattled from a battle from 4-1 down. They have a one-run lead. Bottom of the lineup coming up for the Lady Braves. We'll get to it after this timeout.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one.
Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet.
honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
People who come to Cricket stay with Cricket. Like one of our favorite customers, Michelle.
I started my own app company, and with Cricket, I'm able to answer calls from my engineers and investors and know my signal's going to be great. If I had to describe Cricket in two words, they would be reliable and affordable.
5G boss mode, activate. Smile, you're on Cricket.
Here in Gulfport, glad you can join us. 5-4. I do see some Prairie View players just kind of standing by. Of course, they'll only be needed if Grambling wins this game. If the Lady Braves win this game, we're done for the day. We'll be back at you tomorrow. Panthers are undefeated. They're in the championship. Got to knock them out twice to win it all. Regardless of who they play, here's a ground ball back to the pitcher. One pitch, one out. Christian Edwards, 1-for-4.
Braves with one out.
One out.
Headed to the plate is number 13, Kennedy Terry.
Kennedy Terry at the plate. Erin Gibbs in her third inning of work. It's a pitch strike called. 0-1 the count. Kennedy Terry. The fielder's choice, stole a base, fly to left. RBI single made it 5-3. There's the pitch low. 1-1. Again, if the Lady Braves win this game, they eliminate Grambling and we'll play tomorrow. There's a chopper foul. Grambling rallies and wins this game, eliminate Alcorn, and we'll be back for another game tonight, Prairie View and Grambling. And this is obviously to avoid Alcorn. If they win, it'll be their second win. It could be the third game in a row today. Here's a chopper to first, two away. Fultz steps on the bag.
12 for the Braves.
Two away.
At the plate is number 11, Julius Whale.
He's Whale's at the plate. This pitch strike called. 1-1 the count. Two out. 5-4. Lady Braves with the lead. It's the 0-1. A fly ball in the deep center field. This ball's well hit and it's caught in center. Oh, staying with it is Tamaya Johnson. The side is retired. The stage is set. We go to the bottom of the seventh inning. Lady Braves trying to eliminate Grambling and make it to the championship round. Take a timeout. We'll be right back after this.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one.
Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet. Honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream. All hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool your school. We're powered by purpose.
Welcome back to Gulfport. We've had some really good games here. No blowouts. Competitive from start all the way through, including this game. for the Lady Braves. They're trying to win their third straight one-run game. Trying to eliminate their third opponent in a row. They eliminated Bama State, Bethune-Cookman, and now they're trying to eliminate Grambling. There's the pitch strike called, and we're underway here in the bottom of the seventh inning. 5-4, Lady Braves with the lead. They were once down 4-1. There's the 0-1 from Parker. Misses 1-1. 1-1 the count. Bottom of the seventh inning, just underway. Parker, the third Lady Braves pitcher, she's the number two starter trying to close it out. Here's the 1-1. Low, 2-1. Lady Panthers of Prairie View await. Of course, if Grambling rallies and wins, the Panthers will be playing later. If not, it'll be tomorrow. Here's a 2-1. This is outside, 3-1. 3-1 to count. Top of the lineup for Grambling. Ball four. Tying run is at first. First team, all-conference shortstop, Kadasia Collins. Single to left center, grounded to second, fly to second. Leadoff is on for Grambling. The pitch low and inside, ball one. Time called. Catcher Jillian Walters trying to settle Kiri Parker in. Infielders will huddle up. Leadoff is on. Potential winning run at the plate. Lady Braves once were down 4-1. They led 1-0 on an RBI single by Janice Wells, but Grambling came back with 3 in the first, 1 in the second to lead 4-1. Lady Braves came back and tied in an RBI double by Hunt. An error gave the Lady Braves the lead on a rally across from first to third. No one was home for Grambling. Allowed to run the score. Count is 1-1. Pitch to Collins, coming up from Parker. This is outside, the runner going, and the throw, it gets away. But Moore cannot advance. Well, there's your tying run at second. Looked like that would have been a bang-bang play if it was caught. Good play by Walters. Oh, yeah, it actually hit the runner. Coach Nakia Hall, aggressive. 2-1 the count, tying run at second. Pitch to Collins. It's a wild pitch. Runner to third. Runner at third, tying run at third. Nobody out, the pitch, strike called. Lead off walk to Moore, she stole second. Wild pitch got her the third, she's there, nobody out. Bottom of the seventh inning, 5-4 Lady Braves. Here's the 3-2. Shot down the left side, foul. Shot got Grambling's athletic director, Dr. Travian Scott, who played his collegiate basketball at Southern University. They got him up out of his seat. Count is 4-3-2. Runner at third, nobody out. 5-4, the pitch. Low ball four, first and third. Here comes pitching coach Ambria Dorsey. Two walks. A stolen base, and a wild pitch. We will keep it here, ladies and gentlemen, for the bottom of the seventh inning. There's a lot to unpack right here. And I think Ambria Dorsey has to deal with the defense. And now we got a pitching change coming up here. We might get Alexa Viamoy, the number one starter, in right now. And we will. We'll take a timeout here. Pitching change for the Lady Braves. The number one, Alexa Viamoy, trying to close it out. But Grambling has first and third, nobody out. Down a run, bottom seven. We'll take a break. We'll be right back.
Resume run. Hydration drop. Rapid rehydration initiated. Unlock specialized blend of 5 electrolytes.
Rapid rehydration to get you back on your game. Gatorlyte, now available in powder and Gatorlyte Zero Sugar.
You join the HBCU family. You become part of the tradition and bringing it with everything you do in the classroom and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those adding to it.
Alexa Viamoy, 2-0 in the tournament, 2.10 earned run average. She's pitched 10 innings in this tournament, trying to close it out and send the Lady Braves to the SWAC championship game. But Grambling has first and third, nobody out in the bottom of the seventh inning. India Wells, she's 2-for-3. A lot to unpack here. You assume they'll play it safe. But Collins, pretty good on the paces. Collins stole 9 out of 10 during the regular season. Viamoy to Wells, strike called, and the runner just takes second. They're not concerned about the runner at second right now. But second and third, nobody out. An extra base hit would win it for Grambling. Wells 2-for-3, single to right center, stole a base, an infield single fly to right. 5-4, Alcorn. The pitch misses. Here's a runner trying to score, and she is safe, and we are tied. Two wild pitches in this inning. 5-5 game. Now the winning run is at third. Here's the 1-1 trying to bunt. Did she bunt at it? And the third base umpire says she did. 1-2 the count. Winning run at third for Grambling. They've tied it up at 5. Runner at third, nobody out. Here's the pitch. Foul. Via Wells at the plate. 2 walks, 2 stolen bases, 2 wild pitches in this inning have set it up. Count is 1-2. 1-2 pitch, popped up, foul territory and out of play. Again, if Grambling wins this game, we'll have another game at 6 o'clock, Grambling and Prairie View. Of course, the Panthers are undefeated in this tournament. If the Lady Braves rally and win, we're done today and we'll be back tomorrow. But right now, Grambling, a runner at third, nobody out, 5-5 in the bottom of the seventh. Pitch from Viamoy, ground ball, it is foul. Down the third baseline. Count remains 1-2. The senior, India Wells, at the plate. 5-5 game. Nobody out, runner at third. Viamoy brings it home. Popped up. He caught it second. One away.
One out for
Maya
Blade.
Cotton hauls it in.
Correction, one out for the Tigers.
One out, runner at third.
Runner on third at the plate is number 35.
Warren Irvin. Irvin, 2-for-3. RBI single made it 4-1. Grambling. Lefty facing the righty, Viamoy. This pitch misses, ball one. Five game in the seventh. Alexa Viamoy, the number one on the mound for the Lady Braves. His pitch strike calls. Ashley Strozier at third for Grambling. 1-1 the count, one out. The 1-1. Galton, a shallow center. It's going to be caught in center for the second out. Jen Edwards hauls it in. Two out, runner at third.
Runner still on third at the plate.
Callie Malone will pinch hit for Grambling. Malone in for the catcher, Nia Jones. Grambling has tied it up. Malone at the plate.
Kaylin
Malone hit 217 during the season with a home run and five runs batted in. She's trying to win it for Grambling. The Lady Braves trying to take it to extra innings. Pitch from Viamoy. Strike called. 0-1 the count. Bottom of the seventh inning. Lady Braves led 1-0. Trail 4-1. Led 5-4. Grambling's tied it up. Here's the 0-1. Check swing on a riser. Do they check? Nope. Check to see if he went around. The catcher asked the home plate umpire, Julian Walters. Count is 1-1. Malone, the pinch hitter, in the bottom of the seventh. Here's the 1-1. Here's a shot down the right side. It's going to hook. Foul on the right side. Count is 1-2. Well, the Lady Braves were in this spot yesterday against Bama State. They tied it up, had the winning run. They held fort and they won it. Same position 24 hours later. 1-2 the count. Pitch to Malone. Misses outside. Count is 2-2. Alexa Viamoy, the number one starter, Alabama State transfer. Number one in for the Lady Braves. We've seen the arms for Alcorn. Of course, if they win this game, they won't play again until tomorrow. But they got to get out of this jam. Here's the 2-2. Chopper foul. Foul it off her foot. Malone grimacing in pain. Count remains 2-2. For Coach Fernandez, she's got to put it all out there. I mean, if they win this game, they won't play until tomorrow, so you'll have everyone available anyway. She's throwing everything at it right now. The number one starter in. We've seen the full complement of the Lady Braves rotation in this game. 2-2 pitch to Malone. Extra innings coming up. Grambling gets a run, and we go to the eighth inning. We are tied at 5. Extra softball coming up from Gulfport. We'll take a break. We'll be right back after this timeout.
No hit, no error, one left gone.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future.
all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
Resume run. Hydration dropping. Rapid rehydration initiated. Unlock specialized blend of 5 electrolytes.
Rapid rehydration to get you back on your game. Gatorlyte, now available in powder and Gatorlyte Zero Sugar.
We go to the eighth inning. Lady Braves, Lady Tigers of Grambling, 5-5 game. Again, for the Lady Braves, if they win this game, we're done for the day. Lady Braves will not have to play a third game today. They'll be in the championship game against Prairie View tomorrow. If Grambling wins this game, Lady Braves are eliminated. And tonight at 6 o'clock, it'll be Grambling and Prairie View. Of course, the Panthers undefeated, got to knock them out twice. Eighth inning, almost a carbon copy of Lady Braves, what they went through with Bama State yesterday. Shea Hunt, her RBI double, tied the game at 4. She flied to center and grounded to third. 5-5 game in the eighth. And a fly ball in the shallow center. It's going to be hauled in by Tamaya Johnson.
One out for the Braves.
One away.
And headed to the plate is number one.
Kelsey Lockridge, 0 for 3. Wide to right, grounded to short, and third. One out, base is empty. Pitch strike call. I wonder where the Prairie View players went. They might have went back to their bus. They're dressed and ready to go if needed to play. That's yet to be determined. 0-1 the count, one out. Pitch is low, 1-1. 1-1 the count. Aaron Gibbs on the mound for the Tigers. A three-hopper to short, and quickly two away.
Two out,
bases empty for the Lady Braves as Collins, all-conference shortstop, throws out Lockridge. Makiria Howard trying to keep Alcorn's inning alive here in the eighth inning. For Grambling, it'll be 6, 7, and 8 in the lineup in the bottom of the eighth inning. The pitch, swing and a miss. 0-1 the count. Lady Braves, 3 straight one-run games. 0-1 the count. The 0-1. Foul it off her foot. Howard, walk it off. Count is 0-2, two out. Top of the eighth inning, seesaw game. Lady Braves jumped out 1-0, trail 4-1. Tied it at 4, led 5-4. Grambling tied it at 5. Here we are on the top of the eighth. Back and forth we go. 0-2 the count, two out. The 0-2. This is outside. 1-2. With two wild pitches, two walks. A lot of action for Grambling in that seventh. They got a run out of it, but Viamoy closed the door. Here we are on the eighth. There's a high fly ball into right center, and it's going to be caught in right. Almost collided with her center fielder, Johnson. Hauled in by Russell, and the side is retired in the top of the eighth. 6-7 and 8. Tamiya Johnson lead it off for the Grambling Tigers. Bottom of the eighth inning, 5-5 game. We'll take a break here. We'll be right back in 60 seconds.
When you join the HBCU family, you become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
Hydration dropping. Rapid rehydration initiated. Unlock specialized blend of 5 electrolytes.
Rapid rehydration to get you back on your game. Gatorlyte, now available in powder and Gatorlyte Zero Sugar.
Bottom of the eighth inning, an entertaining game here. Lady Braves, Grambling, tied at 5. Again, if the Lady Braves win this game, it'll be the final game today. Not going to force the Lady Braves to play a third game. They'll eliminate Grambling. So if the Lady Braves win here, we'll play tomorrow. This pitch misses, ball one. Tatiana Robinson at the plate. If Grambling wins this game, since it's their second game of their first game of the day, eliminate the Lady Braves, and they'll play Prairie View tonight. Here's the 1-0. High inside from Viamoy, and she didn't like that pitch. Thought it was inside corner. 2-0 the count. Bottom of the eighth inning, this pitch strike called. 2-1 the count. When we got to the 10th inning of Alcorn and Bama State, you start with a runner, international rules. You start with a runner at second. If we get to the 10th, but we're a ways away from that. 5-5, bottom eight. Here's the 2-1. Misses outside. 3-1 and Viamoy. Kind of confused look. She thought that might have caught the outside corner. Now she's got to step away and kind of regather here. 3-1 the count. A borderline pitches Viamoy thought on the inside and on the outside corner. She thought she might have had. Here's the 3-1. Ground ball. It's a fair ball down the third baseline and trying to get to second, and the throw is too late. A double for Tatiana Robinson. Tickled the third baseline. A double to lead it off. I don't know if they're going to. Is Coach Fernandez going to challenge it? Now, what we've been told, anything after the sixth inning, the umpires can initiate a challenge after the sixth inning. Coach Fernandez. Well, she was 2-for-2 on challenges yesterday. She's challenging on this one down the line. The ruling on the field is that it is fair. But I don't know if she's challenging that or the runner at second. I think she's challenging this right here, the runner at second. I'm going to challenge it down the line. That's what they're challenging. Right down the line. That is close. On this hot, well, we're looking at it from different angles. Again, the ruling on the field is the fair ball. There's got to be something there to overturn the call. Freezing it right on the line. Now, if we were on dirt, you would see some chalk kicked up. Because we're on turf, you wouldn't necessarily see that. Pretty decent look, and they're going to keep it the call as is, a double. So a double is confirmed. And so Grambling has the winning run and a pinch hitter coming up for Grambling. Caitlin Walls will pinch run for Robinson. So the winning run is at second base. Tamaya Johnson, two walks and a ground out and a stolen base at the plate for Grambling.
He's grabbing for the Tiger, the number two, Hannah Miller. Caitlin Wall.
Here's a bunt fielded by Viamoy, and the throw is there, runner to third. So Johnson with the 1-3 sack, and Grambling again with a runner at third with one out, second inning in a row. Johnson is right there in her eyes and laid it down. Viamoy, a good throw. So Deja Russell, the bottom of the lineup for Grambling, the number 8 hitter Russell, 0-for-2. Her bases loaded Walker in her first at bat, made it 3-1, and she's grounded to the pitcher twice in the third and in the sixth. She's up here in the eighth. Trying to win it for Grambling. The pitch. Strike called. Grambling wins this game. We'll have another game here later. Grambling and Prairie View. The Lady Braves rally and win. We're done for the day. Here's the 0-1 from Viamoy, the number one starter, the 0-1. This is outside. 1-1. They're in for the play at the plate. 1-1 the count, one out, 5-5, bottom eight. Viamoy to Russell. High fly ball in the deep right field, and this ball is going to land, and Grambling has won it. Deja Russell, a deep fly ball over the head of Micah Hall, who was playing shallow, anticipating a play at the plate. And Grambling has rallied and won it in the eighth inning, 6-5, eliminating the Lady Braves. What a game here. Lady Braves were down, tied it up, grabbed the lead. Grambling tied it in the seventh, won it in the eighth, 6-5. So we started with eight, we're down to two. It's Grambling and Prairie View. We will have a game tonight. Prairie View undefeated. If Prairie View wins the game tonight, they win the championship. If Grambling wins tonight, we'll see you tomorrow. But we'll take a break here. We'll see you later. Good season for the Lady Braves, the number 4 seed in the West. Fourth elimination game, Lady Braves. Fourth straight one-run game. They come up short, 6-5. So we'll talk to you later. I'm Charles Edmond. Glad you can join us. We'll see you.
People who come to Cricket stay with Cricket. Like one of our favorite customers, Michelle.
I started my own app company, and with Cricket, I'm able to answer calls from my engineers and investors and know my signal's going to be great. If I had to describe Cricket in 2 words, they would be reliable and affordable.
5G boss mode activate. Smile, you're on Cricket.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet. Honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.